In June 2020, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk wrote some tweets about SpaceX's plans to improve its Starship rocket. They are trying to figure out how to land Starship on the moon, and in order to make it better suited to the lunar missions, SpaceX has plans to make some changes to Starship's rocket. These changes mainly focus on the Starship's stability when landing in high winds. So SpaceX won't give up on trying to reach the moon, despite the fact that NASA has selected the Blue Origin national team to return humans to the moon in April 2020 upon identifying some risks in SpaceX's Starship lunar lander proposal. Curious to know more about this ferocious space race and whether SpaceX and Blue Origin can really go to the moon? Keep watching. To get back on track for the sustainable human exploration of the moon and beyond, NASA has started the Artemis Program in 2017 with a cost of approximately $35 billion. The Artemis Program is considered to be the twin sister of the Apollo space program. One of the main objectives of the Artemis Program is to return humans to the moon, where NASA will land the first woman and the next man on the moon by 2024 through that program, and by using the increasingly developing initiative technologies available to many international and commercial partners. However, the objective is not the sole purpose of landing humans on the moon, but also to explore more of the lunar surface than ever before. Assuming that everything will go as planned, by the end of the decade, NASA will establish a sustainable exploration upon collaborating with their international and commercial partners. Then they will send astronauts to Mars upon learning everything they need to know on and around the moon. If the program becomes a success, we will better understand the universe and our home planet through numerous robotic and human activities that are performed on the lunar surface and in orbit around the moon. At least scientists will conduct their technological experiments and investigations from a new perspective, which is the lunar surface and orbit in this case. This will eventually help them understand the Martian circumstances for sure. In order to be able to perform such activities, NASA plans to build sustainable elements on the lunar surface and around the moon, which will allow robots and astronauts to explore the lunar environment and conduct their experiments. NASA has built six main elements in the Artemis program, which are: Number 1. The exploration ground systems, which include all the on-ground structures that are required to support launch. In particular, NASA is updating all the launch facilities located at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida in order to support the Artemis missions to the moon and beyond. Number 2. Space Launch System, which is the world's most powerful rocket that will send humans and cargo to the moon and beyond. The Space Launch System is the agency's first deep rocket that's designed to be flexible and evolvable since Saturn V. Number 3. Orion, which is the spacecraft specified to the lunar missions. It will carry the Artemis crew to lunar orbit, where they will transfer to the Gateway or a human landing system. Then the crew will use it again to return home to Earth safely, since it has been designed and built to withstand the extreme heat and conditions experienced upon re-entry into the atmosphere. Number 4. Gateway, which is the lunar outpost in the moon orbit. It has been designed to support human and scientific exploration in deep space. Built with the international and commercial NASA partners, and the US portion will be designated the Neil A. Armstrong Lunar Outpost, as the United States Congress has directed. This gateway is critical to the sustainability of lunar exploration, and it will for sure serve as a model for Mars future missions. Number 5. Lunar Landers, which are human landing systems. NASA has collaborated with American commercial space companies such as Blue Origin, Dynetics, and SpaceX in order to build these lunar landers to help land humans on the surface of the moon. These land systems will dock with the Orion spacecraft, or the Gateway Outpost, in lunar orbit and take the Artemis crew safely to the lunar surface and back to lunar orbit. Number 6. Artemis Generation Spacesuits, which are modern spacesuits that are compatible with deep space exploration. Astronauts need highly specific and modern spacesuits in the harsh environment of space in order to explore more of the lunar surface than ever before and to be able to conduct their planned experiments easily and efficiently. astronauts will wear the Orion Crew Survival System suit, while NASA's Advanced Exploration Extravehicular Mobility Unity, or XEMU for short, will support lunar surface expeditions during launch and re-entry. So far, we've got a glimpse of the Artemis space program and how NASA is collaborating with commercial partners, including SpaceX and Blue Origin. It's time to investigate their specific roles, contracts, and whether they are going to fully accomplish their responsibilities on time. You may ask yourself why there is a space race between SpaceX, Blue Origin, and Dynetics. After all, NASA is collaborating with the three of them. And to answer that very question, it's worth noting that the three companies are simultaneously building the same category of the Artemis space elements, which are the human landing systems. Moreover, the three partners will independently launch their own lunar landing systems on the ULA Vulcan launch system and the SpaceX Super Heavy rocket. And here comes the competition. Eventually, one company will be the first to successfully launch its landing system, and also one company will be the last. Which one will be the first, and which one will be the last? Who will succeed to land the first woman on the moon? Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, or David King? These are very important questions to bear in our minds. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve our content and make these videos better for you. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. In April 2020, NASA awarded three firm fixed price and milestone-based contracts with a combined value of $967 million for the 10-month base period to the three companies, SpaceX, Blue Origin, and Dynetics. Blue Origin won a contract of $579 million to become the prime contractor for the national team, including Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Draper. Each member of the team will design and build a specific element specialized for a certain role in the landing process. In particular, Blue Origin will build and design the descent element powered by the BE-7 cryogenic engines that are in private development for more than 3 years and based on the Blue Moon lander. Lockheed Martin will build the ascent element, which includes the crew cabin that will have a remarkable resemblance to the Orion spacecraft. Northrop Grumman is developing the future refueling element that is based on Cygnus for more sustainable lander demonstration. Draper will provide several systems regarding the guidance, navigation and control, avionics and software development that are relatively based on similar systems that Draper has developed for NASA. NASA's evaluation of the national team proposal regarding their technical rating and management approach merits is that they have acceptable technical ratings and very good management approach. The most important advantage of the national team contract is that they will simultaneously work on different landing elements, which will be more efficient because it will give them time to test all the elements before assembling them. Dynetics won a contract of $253 million. The contract includes more than 25 subcontractors that are specialized in both the large elements and the small system level components of the Dynetics Human Landing System, or DHLS for short. Dynetics' experience as a military and defense contract integrator is highly demonstrated in that robust team with that large number of subcontractors. Single element that is providing the ascent and descent capabilities along with multiple propellant vehicles prepositioned to fuel the engines at some stages during the mission are considered to be the main features of the DHLS. Moreover, the crew cabin in the DHLS design sits low to the lunar surface, which will enable short jumps for the crew members, along with the ease of entering or exiting and the flexible transportation of tools, equipment, and samples. There are some other advantages regarding the Dynetics design. One of them is that the DHLS systems support both docking with the Orion spacecraft and the Gateway Lunar Outpost. It will also get a fuel top-off before descending to the surface. After completing the expedition, the entire vehicle will return for the crew transfer back to Orion in the low lunar orbit. Additionally, NASA evaluation of Dynetics' proposal is very good technical rating and very good management rating. SpaceX human lander is called Starship. It's a fully reusable launch and landing system that's specially designed for Moon, Mars, and other destinations. The Starship launch and landing system is based on the company's legacy that includes tested Raptor engines and flight heritage of the Falcon and Dragon vehicles. There are two airlocks for astronaut moonwalks included in the Starship spacious cabin, which gives the vehicle the capability to support up to 4 suited astronauts if needed. Moreover, there are several Starships that serve in numerous and distinct purposes in enabling human landing missions, and each one of them is based on the common rendition and design of Starship. The tanker and the propellant storage unit are two Starship-derived vehicles. The propellant storage Starship will be supplied by tanker Starships upon parking in low Earth orbit, where it will launch to the storage unit in Earth orbit, then fuel up and then continue to lunar orbit. Starship will launch from Earth via SpaceX Super Heavy rocket booster that's also fully reusable and powered by Raptor engines. In addition to all of this, Starship lander is capable of transporting the crew between Orion spacecraft, or the Gateway Lunar Outpost, and the lunar surface. Now, you might be wondering why SpaceX won the least contract value of $135 million even after Dynetics. Well, NASA has identified many significant weaknesses in SpaceX's Starship proposal, which are: the Starship propulsion system is, according to NASA, notably complex and comprises likewise complex individual subsystems that have yet to be developed, tested, and certified, with very little schedule margin to accommodate delays. The operations of the launch process and fueling are highly complex and rendezvous that must succeed in extremely quick succession in order to successfully execute on its approach. The past performance of SpaceX associated with Crew Dragon and Falcon Heavy development experienced considerable schedule delays due to many technical issues. This issue influenced NASA's choice because one of the main objectives involves getting astronauts to the moon fast to meet the Trump administration's 2024 schedule goal. It's also worth noting that SpaceX's Starship meets or exceeds all of NASA's threshold requirements. It also supports a sustainable capability with reusable elements and robust capabilities that will help realize the agency's long-term goals for a sustainable and cost-effective lunar surface transportation system. Moreover, priorities early and numerous ground and flight system demonstrations and offers a substantial corporate contribution in funding from SpaceX. Recall that the national team's proposal, led by Blue Origin, meets most of NASA's objectives, such that industry-leading solutions are introduced by each member of the team, where the development of the descent element, mission engineering and operations, safety and mission assurance, systems engineering and project management are all fulfilled by Blue Origin since it's the prime contractor. The development of the reusable ascent element vehicle, along with the crewed flight operations and training, are all fulfilled by Lockheed Martin. The development of the transfer element vehicle associated with the delivery of the landing system into low lunar orbit for the final descent is fulfilled by Northrop Grumman. The leadership of the guidance system providing the flight avionics are fulfilled by Draper. Therefore, NASA objectives of sustainability and time management are pretty much fulfilled by the national team and Blue Origin. That's why they won the $579 million contract. The 10-month base period given by NASA to all the three commercial partners will end in February 2021, so we need to wait and see what will happen. Thanks for watching, everyone. In your opinion, and based on the information given by this video, who will be the first to land on the moon? Do you think that Elon Musk will achieve this goal despite the fact that he won the smallest contract? Or do you think he won't be able to finance his fancy complex launch and propulsion operations? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.